So now let's look at an actual hash function and how it works internally. So we're gonna look at the hash function MD5. So MD5 is a Merkley dump guard construction with length padding. And it works on input blocks of size 512 bits. So it's a Merkley dump guard, so all we have to look at actually is just the underlying compression function. So first padding is length intention padding, and the length is encoded in 64 bits in the padding, but that's a technical detail. So the MD5 compression function is made up of 64 rounds. So first the 512-bit input block that comes in here is split up into 32-bit chunks. So the compression function, as I said, is split up into 64 rounds, and each round looks like this. So here we have 4 32-bit values as the chaining values. Now the chaining values are 128 bits long in MD5. This square here is the addition modulo 32. So in the round function, a 32-bit chunk of the input block is added to these values here. And then a 32-bit value of a predefined constant that is in the MD5 standard is added to it, and then it's left shifted by S bits, where S is also predefined in the MD5 standard and varies per round. Another thing to notice here is the predefined nonlinear round function that adds all the chaining values together to this 32-bit value. And in the end, these values are somewhat scrambled around, and that's one round of the round function that consumes 32 bits of the input message and a 128-bit chaining value. So there are four different round functions for the 64 rounds, and they look like this. You don't have to worry too much about those. Those are nonlinear functions that just truly scramble the input, hash it around, and G here is the next index of the input of the message block. So the calculation here is just a fancy way of going through input blocks in a different order. So MD5 is a Merkley dump guard, and the compression function is actually this weird round construction executed 64 times. So it consumes 32 bits, or overall 512 bits. So it really works by, in the first block here, by using the IV as a chaining value and then adding M0 to this line, and then the output as it is used for the next round, and so on and so forth, 64 times. And then we have an output that is Y1, which is actually the next chaining value, or in the end, the actual hash value. So the output is just the last chaining value, which is 128 bits or 16 bytes. That is this output here, or the last chaining value.